For more updates, click on subscribe and click on bell button for latest notifications. Hi friends, welcome to Tech ARKIT YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to see that a little small trick or a little small software which can be used to convert your MBR disk type to GPT disk type without losing the data.
Like, share, comment, and subscribe.
So how you can use this tool and how you can convert your MBR type disk to GPT, so which is a non-OS disk. You can easily convert without any data loss. So you don't need to pay anything. It is an open source software, so you have to no need to install the software anymore. It's just an .exe file, you have to use it. So before that, MBR disk is called as a name master boot trigger disk, which most of the times we use as a basic disk. Like the disk is within from 1 MB to 2 TB in size, which can support with the NTFS file system. But if you want to go behind 2 TB in size, okay, then what you have to do is that you have to convert the disk to GPT disk, then expand that disk behind the 2 TB. So in this just I'm going to show you example with this 20 GB disk drive. So which is, if I show you here, so if I go to here and see this, this is a master boot record type partition, style is master boot record. So in this, I'm just going to convert this master boot record style partition style to GPT without losing its drive data. So you can just see this, it has some data in it, and I just wanted to convert this drive to the GPT without losing any data over here. So before jumping into this, so as a caution, you have to keep a backup ready, because I don't know, maybe something goes wrong with your disk, your data may be lost. So as a precaution, you just have to take a full backup of the drive before that. So if it is an important data, so that maybe sometimes you may do a wrong steps or the data may go lost. Okay, so avoid that such kind of things. So take a full backup copy of this disk and try this method. So first of all, you have to go to disk part and say list disk. So here you can see this, I have two disks, and two disks are not GPT. So if it is GPT, you can see this GPT star over here. So this is the disk 1 and this is the disk 0. The disk 0 has C drive and the system files, and D drive has a single partition with no logical volumes in it, and it's a basic MBR drive, MBR partition. So now I'm just going to convert this into the GPT. So before that, you have to just know that what is your disk number you are just going to convert. Just make sure that is the disk you are just going to convert over here. So and go and download the software called gptgen. So that's the software I'm just going to use in this here. So I'm just going to use that software called gptgen. So here I'm in gptgen, and go to gptgen.exe, and you have to type the option called W. So immediately write this GPT partition style into the disk itself. So how you can write that, and put it //.// and physical drive and disk number. So the disk number is physical disk, not physical drive 1. So this is the spelling, there is no spelling mistake, you have to check it up. Physical drive one. So this is the one command, you have to just type it. So now what it says, that the boot zero and time sector, something, the length of the sectors, how many sectors are there, it shows. And writing the primary GPT protective MBR to the LBA address, so which will create the GPT LBA address over here, and the disk is going to be an GPT. So now just go ahead and refresh this one and properties, and see this, you can GUID partition table. So the partition style has been changed from MBR to GPT, and now you can go ahead and see that whether the disk drive data is there or not. Okay, so the data is intact without losing our data. We just converted the disk is from MBR disk type to GPT disk type. So this is what you can use, this is a simple .exe file which is called gptgen, is a tool non-destructively convert hard disk partitioned in common MS DOS style from MBR to GPT. So you can use this .ext file to convert this any of the disk, but we should not contain any logical drives, and which is not in a dynamic disk. Most probably dynamic disk also works sometimes, but sometimes it is not. So that's why you have to very very careful while using this .exe file. So make sure you have a full backup of it, in case something goes wrong you can restore it back. Thanks for watching, stay tuned, please subscribe to the channel for more upcoming videos and courses. Thanks for watching. Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.